Hey girl, let's talk crime. So this is 15-year-old Alyssa Bustamante, and she was born to her teenage parents in January of 1994. So Alyssa was one of four children. Her mother, Michelle, had her when she was just 15 years old. Her mother, Michelle, struggled with addiction, and her father was in and out of prison. She and her siblings would often move. There was just really no stability, and it really had an effect on the children. When Alyssa was 9 years old, her grandparents had taken in her and one of her younger brothers. Eventually, her grandparents were able to get custody of all four of the children, and then they all ended up moving to a small town called St. Martin's in Missouri. Once Alyssa was a teenager, she hit this rebellious stage. Although she performed well in school and she was pretty popular, she still had this really dark side to her where she liked really sinister things. She also struggled with depression, and then she also struggled with self-harm. Her grandparents never leaving her corner really ensured that she had received the best care that she possibly could, which was inpatient and outpatient care. In 2007, when Alyssa was 13 years old, she was hospitalized after slitting both of her wrists in an attempt to end her life. So on October 21st, 2009, this little girl, 9-year-old Elizabeth Olton, who is the neighbor of Alyssa, was super excited to be home and rehearsing because she had landed a role in a school stage play. Around 5 p.m., there was a knock on the door, and it was Emma, which is Alyssa's younger sister, and she was asking if Elizabeth could come outside to play. Now, Elizabeth's mother, Patty, had initially said no because it was so close to dinner. However, Emma was just please, can we just play out at least for an hour? And then, she can come back by 6. And then Patty agreed, hey, make sure you're back by 6. Go and have fun. So 6 p.m. rolls around and there's no sign of Elizabeth. And so her mother ends up calling her phone. However, it's going straight to voicemail. She reaches out to her parents, asking if they had seen Elizabeth. They hadn't. She had gone out looking for her, and at that point, panic set in, and she had called authorities to report that her daughter was missing. So once authorities had arrived on the scene, Patty, Elizabeth's mother, had told them that she was last playing with Emma, which is Alyssa's younger sister. And so that's where authorities did start their investigation, speaking with Emma at her grandparents' home. So Emma tells authorities that they had played together a little bit in the woods, and then when 6 o'clock hit, then Elizabeth had headed home as she was instructed to do so. So during this time that they are speaking with Emma, there is a search going on. People in the neighborhood have been helping. Multiple agencies were looking. And at one point, they began to ask Emma more questions and really try to get more information from her because they sensed that she wasn't telling the entire truth. So Emma ends up telling authorities that it wasn't her idea at all to even ask Elizabeth to come outside and play. Her older sister, Alyssa, had instructed her to go and ask her to come outside and play. Once Elizabeth came over to play, at some point they did play in the woods for a brief moment before her older sister, Alyssa, had told her to go inside. And at that point, Emma didn't think much about it. She just went inside as she was told. And so after speaking with Emma, they began to question Alyssa. Now, Alyssa was very chill, just saying oh, I came home from school, I was in my room, nothing really happened. But what she did not know is that her grandparents had allowed authorities to search the home, specifically her room, and they did find a diary inside. Now, in this diary, there was an entry dated from August 21st, 2009, the day that Elizabeth had gone missing. Now, a lot of it was crossed out, but they were able to decipher exactly what it said. And it read, "I just effing killed someone. I strangled them and slit their throat and stabbed them. Now they're dead. I don't know how to feel at the moment. It was amazing. As soon as you get over the, oh my God, I can't do this feeling, it's pretty enjoyable. I'm kind of nervous and shaky right now. Okay, I gotta go to church now. LOL." So Alyssa, even with this evidence, kept trying to deny anything. And then eventually she states, yes, we were in the woods. However, she had fallen, she had hit her head, and I panicked. And so instead of calling authorities, I ended up burying her. So authorities knew that this was not true, as her diary had said something completely different. And eventually Alyssa did say, yes, we had walked deep into the woods, and it was at that point that I knew that this was going to be her last night alive. Once in the woods, she had began strangling 9-year-old Elizabeth Olton, and then she began stabbing her, ultimately slitting her throat. After ending the 9-year-old's life, she then buried her and went home, washed off, and prepared for church as if nothing had happened. After confessing, she had led authorities to the grave where she had buried 9-year-old Elizabeth Olton. Initially, Alyssa was charged with first-degree murder, and she had pled not guilty. And then she had accepted a plea deal of second-degree murder and was given life in prison with the possibility of parole after 35 years. However, in 2021, a law was put in place that stated anyone that was under the age of 18 at the time of their crime and was given more than 15 years in prison would be eligible to have parole after just 15 years. And now Alyssa, who has committed this heinous crime, is eligible for parole in July 2024. She will only be 30 years old.